Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Brittany Simon, and today's video we're going to cover OnlyFans and the new policy change. As you guys know, I'm a content creator on OnlyFans. I really like being there. It's a ton of fun. Now, I am, in regards to nudity and sex positivity, a person who believes like freedom matters. I live in the USA. We understand that there are complications in regards to how people process payments in this country, and therefore it limits the work that sex workers create or adult content creators can create, and it makes it harder for them to get paid. Right now, I know many of you guys already know this, the major controversy is that the big banks aren't allowing partnerships with adult companies because they're afraid of their image. And specifically, they don't want to be associated with child trafficking. After the Pornhub debacle, where we realized there were minors featured on the site, I think a lot of companies are hesitant to support sex workers because of the stigma. On one hand, I respect that because we want to protect children. And on the other hand, I'm worried because as an adult content creator myself, I think there's a place for it in the world. And I understand we're living in a moment of time of human history, and though, you know, exchanging sex for money has been a part of the human experience since the beginning, I think it's still a complicated subject. I think there's a lot of really good reasons one would be hesitant to be pro-sex work. And at the same time, I think it's really important that we acknowledge freedom matters. And I would like to enjoy that freedom with my one existence, my one life. See, I fundamentally believe, without a doubt, that this is it. This is all I have. So if that's the case, I really can't imagine limiting adults from expressing themselves via nude art or porn because it makes me uncomfortable. So I wouldn't do that to someone else. I hope someone doesn't do that to us. But with the changes, it seems like people who are making porn, boy-girl stuff, masturbation videos, they're not going to be allowed to post anymore on OnlyFans. It's pretty typical that a company would use sex workers to boost themselves up and then, of course, to drop them in the end because there's more money and family-friendly things. Like, YouTube did the same thing. I remember when I was first on YouTube, I could be naked online without age-restricting it, and it was so much fun, and then they made me age-restrict it, and it was a whole debacle. Things change. Like, I just don't think it's that deep, right? It's just, it's what happens. So what we have to do now is adapt. Now, okay, you can do this. This is not that hard. I promise you, if my parents can make it across the ocean to come to the States from Iraq, you can learn how to post nude on OnlyFans without doing crazy erotic things, okay? I think we can do this one. So don't lose hope. If you feel like you're a nude content creator, you want to keep being nude, OnlyFans will allow you to stay on the platform and do that. I know for myself personally, my work has never been conventional anyways. So to be honest, this doesn't really impact me the way that some might think it would. I actually am going to be, if anything, more motivated to really up my game. I'm really excited. I'm a weird editor. I have a lot of fun with my photography. I'll show some examples on the screen. Of course, these are censored and they're uncensored on OnlyFans. But for me, I think I'm trying to cultivate that like queer LGBT audience anyway, slash people who are sex positive, or at least people who are chill. Because at the end of the day, like, I've been around nudist groups for, you know, decades. I've had these experiences with naked people in my life. I just can't get back into the headspace where I think that naked bodies are weird. I've been naked too long. You know, I'm clothing indifferent. I'm okay with the human form. I've been to the Seattle naked bike rides, the solstice parades, BDSM events, Folsom in San Francisco. I mean, there's just really no form of the human body when naked that's really gonna impact me or traumatize me. Now, I recognize, right, like, sex work isn't for all people, and some people might have issues with this, again, for a lot of reasons, but ultimately, when things change around us, when the world of the twos decides to limit our experience, we have to move around it. Whether we're twos or not, we move within the world. We have to acknowledge it exists and move around it. Some might do it through protests, some might do it through adapting. I recommend a little bit of both. Make your stance clear, make it clear this is not cool. And at the same time, don't give up money and an opportunity to have a job online from the safety of your home because you don't want to go with this policy. I know when Tumblr changed, I left. It was really hard for me to justify having a Tumblr after they fucked over sex workers the way they did. And that was actually the start I had with my nude journey. I was so uncomfortable being naked in my early 20s. And then, you know, it's one clothing piece at a time, getting comfortable in my body, feeling very okay with just being raw. And that started on Tumblr. I remember posting my first shoot there. It was really nice. It was a really good experience for me. Now, it's not for all of us, right? I don't think everyone needs to be naked or everyone needs to be on OnlyFans. That's really silly, right? There are a lot of religious people in this community. There are a lot of people who are anti-nudity. that's fine, right? If you're living in a world of the twos and you're experiencing a two bubble, a culture in which nudity is still not okay with you, that's fine. I'm not going to go get naked in front of my parents, right? Like, respect the boundaries. And at the same time, I don't like the idea that they would have to come into my bubbles and stop me either, but we know that's happening. So this isn't just coming from the banks. The banks are doing it because the people still feel uncomfortable with nudity. At the end of the day, people like my conservative parents, who are lovely, wonderful humans, are still very uncomfortable with sex positivity, and so they're going to be the ones that the banks are trying to appeal to. So as culture changes, as the two bubbles shift, we're going to have another moment in time in which sex work is more accepted, and there's ways to do it that have been better than we've done it before. I've talked to a lot of sex workers like Morgan Thorne, who actually helped in Canada try to move bills forward to legalize sex work, but found that even the system in its current state doesn't quite understand the difference between honest freedom and freedom that has so many loopholes it basically is still a prison. And so again, we have to acknowledge, in terms of where we're at personally, where the world is at, and then balance our life between the two realities. Again, the way I live in my house is chill and amazing and, you know, sex positive and queer, you know, queer safe. It's like all these beautiful things. But once I leave that front door, I'm playing in a playground with a bunch of adults. So we have to just take into consideration how those bubbles might interact and some of the issues we might have. But ultimately, I do believe people are good. I don't know that for a fact, but I do believe it. And it continues to be reflected in the life around me. This seems like a really big blow to sex work. And at the same time, we're going to get through it. Not a big deal. Brush it off. You'll be fine. Adapt and protest when appropriate. Be strategic. All right. Talk to you guys soon. Bye. Also, guys, I wanted to announce, in case some of you were not aware, you can email me now to do calls. Many of you guys know I offered calls through Patreon, but some of those slots are taken up. So if you guys want, you can book half an hour times with me or hour times with me. If you go through Venmo or PayPal, links down below for all that information. You just email me what you want to talk about, how much time you want to, you know, talk, and then we'll connect either on Skype or Google Chats or whatever we end up using. But this idea is to help facilitate conversations. I know for me, I've always wanted access to YouTubers that I love to watch, and I would absolutely pay a dollar amount to talk to them. So that's why I ended up doing this and making it my career as a professional conversationalist and listener. For those who are new, I'm just here to help you along your journey. I'm definitely not the destination. I'm just like a stepping stone. You know, like any good anime arc, you know, the main protagonist has to go through and meet all these people to be who they're going to be. I'm just one of those people you're going to meet along the way. And I hope to be a help to you on that journey. All right. Talk to you guys soon. Bye.